If I die young, bury me inside, lay me down. What type of toddler was Heather? A non-clothed one. The child would not wear clothes. She'd run around in either a diaper or panties. That was it. She was should have been a tomboy. She played with all the little boys till she got older, and then it was all little girl. And she was very sneaky. She thought that she could just sneak and get away with a lot of things, but it didn't work.
And then Heather Armstrong is my little sister. We have so many memories together, it's hard to bring up just one. The one that I always think about the most is when we were little kids. We lived in Germantown on Elm Street. We used to sit around all day after school and just play Twisted Metal on PlayStation 1. I miss that a lot. Funny memories I have with Heather, she was always the biggest prankster I ever knew. Like, she would scare my mom all the time, scare me and my other sister Ashley. She would give my mom the best though. My mom would pass out with like a glass in her hand or something, and Heather would run up and scare her, and she would spill that glass all over her. And it was hilarious. But, you know, she wasn't always funny. Like, she might have been a little skinny person, but you didn't want to mess with her back in the day in high school. Like, if I needed somebody to beat up or something, I would go tell her, and it didn't happen.
What reminds me of Heather the most? Her son, Caden. Looks just like her, acts just like her, got the little tongue thing going on just like her. That's what reminds me the most of Heather.
What is the tongue thing?
If she was drawing or coloring or anything, the tongue would do this, and Caden does the exact same thing.
We talk about life being unfair. It's June 17th, 2011, your 22nd birthday. You're celebrating it at a family reunion, the first one in 12 years. And your relatives can't stop talking about how much you've grown, how motherhood has changed you, and how your infant son has your smile. It's good to be Heather Nicole Armstrong. That night in Garrison, Kentucky, after riding courses and swimming, you make the short walk from the pool to the house. You've had asthma since you were two, and lately your mother Angel has been telling you to consult a doctor. You finally make an appointment for the end of July. That's when the asthma attack hits. You can't breathe. The harder you try, the more you struggle. You gasp for air, but there is none. You collapse. Your relatives dial 911. Your mother and sister frantically begin CPR. And eventually, after what seems like an eternity, you're transported to the local hospital. And that's where you die.
I just turned my world upside down. I have bad days all the time now. It's affected Caden. I feel so bad for him.
What's Cheryl's guy?
An angel.
She's an angel.
Yeah. Love you, mommy.